Turn your Bibles to Acts 27:14-25. It says, but not long after there arose against it a tempestuous wind called Euryclidon. And when the ship was caught and could not bear up into the wind, we let her drive. And running under a certain island, which is called, we had much work to come by the boat, which when they had taken up, they used helps on undergirding the ship, and fearing lest they should fall into the quicksand, straight sail, and so were driven. And we, being exceedingly tossed with a tempest, the next day the light tinned the ship. And the third day we casted out our own hands for the tackling of a ship. And when neither sun nor stars in many days appeared, and no small tempest lay on us, and all hope that we should be saved was then taken away. But after a long absence, Paul stood forth in the midst of them and said, Sirs, you should have hearkened unto me and not have moved from Crete, and to have gained this harm and loss. And now I exhort you to be of good cheer, for there shall be no loss of any man's life among you but the ship. For there stood by me this night the angel of God, who I am and whom I serve, saying, Fear not, Paul, thou must be brought before Caesar, and will God have given thee all of them that sail with me before, sir, be of good cheer, for I believe God that it shall be even as was told me. Look at verse 42. It says, And the soldiers' counsel was to kill the prisoners, lest any of them should swim out and escape. But the centurion, willing to save Paul, kept them from their purpose and commanded that they which could swim could cast themselves first into the sea and get to land, and the rest some on board and some on broken pieces of the ship. And so it came to pass that they all escaped, all safe to the land. Okay. How many of you like thunderstorms? I know I do. But my brother was a different way. When he was little, he heard a story on the news about a flood. The next time there was a storm, he was awake half the night, worried that the house would be swept away in the flood. Even though floods never happened where I live, he was super worried about it. There was a man in the Bible who had a lot to worry about. His name was Paul. He was in a storm, a really bad one, called Euryclidon. He was in a storm in a ship in the middle of the sea. It looked like all was lost. Many people were worried that they were going to die. Paul could have worried, but he didn't. He trusted in God. I would like to preach to you why Paul did not worry. My first point is the Lord stood by me. Go to Acts 27 verse 3 again and 23 again. For there stood by me this night the angel of God, whose I am and whom I serve. Paul knew that the Lord was with him. When you are in fear and danger, the Lord is with you. We will not worry if we remember God is always with us. My second point is the Lord showed me. Go to verse 24 and 25, saying, "Fear not, Paul, thou must be brought before Caesar, and though God hath given me all that sail with thee." And Paul told by God that all things would work out. Paul showed us that in his word, how everything works out. We will not worry if we trust in the Bible. My third point is the Lord saved me. Go to verse 42 to 44. And the soldiers' counsel was to kill the prisoners, lest any of them should swim out and escape. But the centurion, willing to save Paul, kept them from their purpose and commanded that they which could swim should cast themselves first in the sea and get to land, and the rest some on board and some on ship, and some on broken pieces of the ship. And so it came to pass that they escaped all safe to the land. God kept his promise to Paul that and everything worked out. God keeps his promises no matter what. We will not worry if we trust that he will work it all out. We may never be caught in a storm in the sea, but we all will fear in our lives. So don't worry. This teaches us that God is with us. We can trust in his word, and he always keeps his promises.
Amen.
Good job.